Marco, thank you very much.
Thank you, Gianmario. Great to see you.
So we are shooting for the second time at LinkedIn, our executive chat, and it's great to have you here as a guest.
Thank you. I'm very happy and honored to be here.
So let me get started with a question. So we are even living years of technology disruption, and paradoxically, someone says that a bachelor degree in philosophy is great. I find this idea, you know, fascinating, but I've never met a CEO like you that actually did something like that. What did you do exactly, and was it really useful?
Yes, indeed. I did an undergraduate degree at the LSC in philosophy and economics, and it was very useful. After that, I went into banking, so I learned the finance after, so I wouldn't recommend just doing philosophy.
Sure.
But where philosophy came in really handy and still comes in handy, I find, is when we, it teaches you about having different opinions on the same topic. In a way that maybe if you study hard science, you just want to get to the right answer as opposed to multiple answers to the same issue. And I find that very helpful also negotiating and managing people to be able to look at different perspectives. I think it's very good.
So you have worked for some of the most important utility companies in Italy, Enel, Eni, and now Snam. And you started, as you mentioned before, in Goldman Sachs. Is it important to have a background in finance to work in utility companies?
I think for me it was very special after coming out of this humanities degree to really take finance seriously, get trained. Banking is, I think, a great opportunity to learn. It's tough. Some weeks you work 110 hours, but you really get the training that you probably don't get anywhere else. And then when you leave a bank like Goldman Sachs, you're an alumni forever. So you still go back to the headquarters, you feel at home, your friends are still there. So I think it's something I really advise. I know it's not as trendy as it used to be. When I graduated, 50% of my class was aiming to get into banking. I think now there's a lot more companies out there that are attractive.
That's true, that's true. And one of the characteristics of Snam and the other utility company you work for is the complexity, I would say, not only of the business, but also the interface with politics in years in which politics is not at its best, let me put it this way. So can you elaborate on this complexity?
Well, I think there's a little bit of a stereotype, especially internationally, that maybe the governance of Italian state-run utilities or public companies is not that straightforward. I must say I've worked in the companies you mentioned for 17 years and I've seen 9 government changes, and I've never seen any government ask something to any of these companies that wasn't in the interest of shareholders. At the end of the day, these are public companies, they have their boards, they have independent directors, and politics is helpful when you do business to business, government to government on top of the business to business. So like entering countries like China wouldn't be possible without strong political support.
Of course. Marco, you're a big supporter of the notion of purpose. I would like you to share with us the purpose of Snam and how did you come up with that?
So we went back, going back to philosophy, we used something that Aristotle said. Aristotle said that a human being with a purpose is much more motivated. And the purpose is in the intersection between what someone is really good at doing, what his talents are, sure, and what the world needs. So we went through a long journey, a lot of introspective work, almost like a company psychoanalysis. And we really came up with what our strengths were and what we think the world needs. And we defined our purpose as energy to inspire the world. But it's not enough just to have a purpose. The purpose is on top. The purpose says what you're for, why you exist. Then you need to have the mission, the vision, the strategy, the values, the competences. So it's an entire framework, but it really makes a difference.
I'm sure that Generation Z will love this notion of purpose. You also teach the Master of Science at Bocconi, but let me ask you...
I love that.
Thank you very much. Let me ask you, what would you suggest to students that are not necessarily attracted to the utility sectors and to Snam in order to find their jobs and so utility companies as first employers?
Trust me, we're not on top of the list of many students, but we made a lot of progress. In fact, I started the employer branding after one of the student days at Bocconi, where I forced the company to go, and we weren't very popular. Because if you're not B2C and you don't have advertising and you're not a household name, people tend to be attracted to the brands they know. We've come a long way. We created a Snam Institute. We're doing, I think, well now on employer branding. What I always remind students is that a stellar career in what they think is a dull sector is much more satisfying than a dull career in a stellar sector. So beware of these great companies where competition is so great, it's actually very hard to have a stellar career. But today I would say that energy, and Snam in particular, we're rewriting the rules of the game. So there's room for creative talent, for financial talent, for strategic talent, a lot of technical talent. So I think one can find today in utilities something to suit there and maximize their full potential.
So we are at LinkedIn, and I have to ask you a question on social networks. You're very active on social networks. Do you find it useful?
We started recently. We find it very helpful. It's a way to speak directly to our stakeholders. It actually helps a lot to engage our internal teams because they can get instant feedback. It makes me more accessible. It gives them the feeling that I'm talking to them and to the other stakeholders. You need to do it with authenticity, I feel, and transparency, and choose different mediums to actually just get the message across. We're undergoing such radical transformation in the company and in the sector that I think my job as a CEO is that to constantly communicate and motivate people, and this is a very, very powerful tool to do that.
It becomes everything more direct and transparent.
Direct, transparent, accessible, visible, explicit.
Terrific. Marco, thank you very much for the time
you have
dedicated to me.
Thank you. I really enjoyed this talk.
Next time I'll see you at Bocconi.
Yes.